Hello and welcome to Ramco TV. My name is Rick Hillmer and I'm one of the automation specialists for Ramco. Today we'll be looking at the ID run options for the ACS880. This tuning will enable you to dial in control to get the most out of your process. Let's take a look. ABB's proprietary direct torque control algorithm, or DTC, can provide very precise speed and torque control, even at low or no speed without the use of a feedback device. But to do this, the drive needs to know exactly how the motor behaves. So when running in DTC mode, you must always do some type of motor ID run. The ACS880 has several variations of ID runs. Today we will focus on just two of them. All drives require motor nameplate data during setup. The ACS880 is no different. After setting all motor nameplate data into group 99, which is the case for all ABB drives, we will set 99.13 to the preferred ID run method. If you cannot disconnect your motor from your machine, you can do a standstill. This will only magnetize your motor, but may cause it to rotate slightly. Once you select standstill, your keypad will display a warning saying that an ID run is about to be performed. With your drive in local control, you can just now press the start button to perform the ID run. This takes about 30 seconds. Once complete, ID run done is displayed. You can now proceed with the rest of the drive setup. The preferred type of ID run for most applications is normal. The motor must be disconnected from its load for this test. My load in this demo case is just a small plastic wheel, so I will leave it on. Again, change parameter 99.13. But this time change it to normal. Then with my drive in local control, I press the start button on the keypad. This starts the ID run, which takes about 90 seconds. First, the motor does not spin while the drive is calculating the required magnetizing current for the motor. This would be the equivalent of the standstill ID run. Once this is done, the motor is accelerated to full speed in the forward direction, then given several different speed settings and torque pulses. You can see the different speeds and current outputs changing by the analog outputs here. Or by the keypad. When done, the motor stops, ID run is displayed, and the system is ready to go. Note that if an ID run fails, there is something wrong, usually either with the drive limits or motor connections. Check both of these and try again before proceeding. If you have any questions on these drives or any of your other applications, give us a call. We'd be happy to help. Thank you.